Everything that can be invented has been invented. This was said 110 years ago by the commissioner of the US Patent Office in justifying why he thought his office should be closed. The same optimism has characterized the current era that we often talk about as the knowledge economy, the information age. Listen to this quote: "The powers of mind are everywhere ascendant over the brute force of things." This has caused economists, for example, to argue that we should no longer be emphasizing physical capital in our models of growth, but intangible capital, which includes R&D, patents, number of scientists, which we didn't include in our growth models in the past. And this is translated into economic policy, both at the national and the transnational level, in terms of convincing countries to spend a lot of money on R&D. For example, the Lisbon Agenda trying to convince European countries to spend at least 3% of their GDP on research and development. You would think that these policies actually had a microeconomic foundation. For example, that we could actually show that firms that spend more in R&D or that patent more actually grow more. But interestingly, we don't actually have any of these results. No studies have shown that in a really rigorous way. In fact, some studies have even shown a negative relationship. My co-author and I, Pelin Demirel, have found that in the pharmaceutical industry, in fact, most firms don't reap any growth benefit from their research and development, only those with certain types of characteristics in place. Now, this suggests that what policy should be doing is emphasizing those mix of characteristics that must be in place in order for research and development to actually affect growth of firms. Instead, we're just asking firms to spend a lot on R&D.